Howdy folks, my name is Boone and I have a YouTube channel called Boone Loves Video where I show how to create different types of map animations inside of Adobe After Effects. In this five-part Learn from the Pros tutorial series from Adobe, I'm going to show you step-by-step how to create one of these map animations. First, I'm going to show you how to create and animate a simple path with markers on a map. Next, we'll take all this into 3D space, light it up, and then finally add some movement and depth to the scene. Essentially, you're going to learn how to quickly and easily bring life to a flat 2D layer, and these techniques really translate to any project or workflow. So let's get into the first part where we're going to create a map path and some markers using some basic shape layers. Okay, I'm inside of my Adobe After Effects project, and I downloaded this beautiful old map from Adobe Stock, and I'm going to go ahead and bring this down into my comp here. And if you look, it's quite large. It's really high resolution, and that's good. I need that because I'm going to be bringing a camera in and flying it around. So I want to see nice detail on this map. And you can see the resolution over here in the preview panel, and this map comp is actually Ultra HD 4K. So this is good size. Now I actually want to scale this down and have it fit perfectly in the comp. So I can just right click on it and go to transform. And then down here, I'm going to select fit to comp width. So for the first step, I want to draw like a path that's going across my map here. So I'm going to go and grab the pen tool, and then over here, I'm going to click on fill, and I do not want to fill. So I'm going to click on this little button here that says none, so that'll turn that off. And then for stroke, I'm going to go click on the color palette to change this, and I'm going to bring the brightness down to like 90%. Click OK. And then I'm going to change the width here in pixels all the way down to 5. And now I can go over here with the pen tool, and I want my path to start off screen like this, and as I click, I'm going to click and drag to create these Bezier handles. And now it's going to kind of go around here to Madagascar, over to Africa, up here to Europe, over here, and then off of this side here. So now I've got this new shape layer down on my timeline panel. I'm going to click on it, hit enter, and rename it path. And if you look at it, it's, you know, you can't see it. It's not very visible. So I need to bring the brightness of my map layer down. So I'm going to go to Window and look for Effects and Presets Panel. And then I'm going to do a keyword search for Exposure. This is a little color correction effect. I'm going to grab this and place it on top of the map. And then I'll just bring the master exposure down by like -1. And now you can see that's a little bit more visible now. And now I want to customize this stroke a bit. So I'm going to open up my layer here, go to Contents, Shape, and then I'm going to open up the stroke parameters. And down here, there's a little group called dashes. And I'm just going to click on this plus button, and that's going to add dashes. And I'm just going to go ahead and go with the default. There's a lot of extra parameters that you can adjust here, but I like this look. Next up, I want to draw the map markers. So I'm going to go over here to the Shape tool. I'm going to click and hold and select the ellipse tool. And now I'm gonna go over to fill, click on the word fill, and set it to solid color. And then I'm gonna click on the color palette, and I'm gonna change it to this white color, and I'm gonna set the brightness to 90. And then I'm gonna go over to stroke, and I'm gonna turn this one off completely, just set it to none. And now to quickly draw an ellipse, first I need to make sure I don't have anything selected in the timeline panel, because if I have the shape layer selected, for example, it's gonna add a shape to this shape layer, and I want it to create a new shape layer. With everything deselected, I'm gonna hold shift and I'm gonna double click on the ellipse tool. Shift double clicking is not only gonna add this shape right in the middle of your comp, but it's also gonna make it perfectly symmetrical. Now over here, you can see the new properties panel. Now this is new as of April 2022. Just an FYI, I'm currently working in the beta version of After Effects because I'm recording these tutorials in March of 2022. So if you happen to see this right when it's released, there may be a chance that you don't have these features available. So you can simply download the beta version of After Effects or just wait until April for these features to be released. Now I'm going to go over here and click the layer, hit enter and rename it map marker. And to change the size over here in the properties panel, I'm going to click on size and I'm going to change this to 30, hit enter. Now I have this little map marker. And if you can't see properties panel, simply go to window and select properties here and then make sure you have your layer selected to see all the properties. Now I'm going to deselect and reselect the layer and I want to move it around now. I'm going to set this first map marker directly over Antarctica. Now I want it to be right on my path. So to make sure that it snaps to the path, as I move it around, I can hold control and it's going to automatically snap it there. One other thing to be aware of is when you're moving these around, make sure you don't accidentally grab the bounding box because that's going to, you know, change the scale. You want to grab inside and then once again, hold control and that will snap. And now I can quickly duplicate these, hold control D and then move this up here. Hold control and I'm going to put it right over Madagascar. Control D again, place this one somewhere over Africa. Control D again. Let's put a marker over Europe. One last Control D and one last marker over here. Now it's time to bring everything together with an animation. So I'm gonna go grab the path and I'm gonna open up the properties, and there's this little add button. I'm gonna click on this so I can add a trim paths animator. That's gonna add this new group down here. I open this up, and to essentially animate this path on, all I need to do is animate the end parameter. So I'm gonna add a keyframe here, and I'm gonna bring the end keyframe maybe at about 5 seconds, and then I'll bring the playhead to the beginning and switch the end parameter to 0. And now you can see if I solo this, we now have this path animating on over the course of 5 seconds. Now I can animate the scale of each map marker as the path hits it to reveal it. So I'm gonna grab map marker 1, hit S for scale, and I'm gonna add a quick scale animation. Just go from 0 to 100. I'll grab these, right click, and add some easy ease here. And now I can grab scale here and copy it. And then I'm gonna go over, move the playhead so that when the path meets the second map marker, and just grab the map marker and then paste that scale, and then do the same thing here for this one. It's a quick way to animate these. Now you can see if I grab all these and hit the U keyboard shortcut key, and let's have a look. And there we go, now I've got my animated path as well as the map markers. Okay, so there you have it. Using some basic shape layers, I've animated this route with a few map markers. In the next episode, I'm going to be preparing everything in 3D space.